There's a line in the Iliad, in Homer's Iliad, that he attributes to Priam, the king of Troy. And he says, I too was numbered among them on that day when the Amazons came, women the equal of men. And when I saw that, I just loved that line. And I thought, you know, people think when they read the Iliad and the Odyssey that this is just pure legend, right? It's not really true. But they said that about Troy, about Homer's descriptions of Troy, that always making this up, it could never have been like that. And then Schliemann went to the actual site of Troy, dug up the city, and it was all exactly the way Homer had said. So I'm one of the people who believes in these ancient lines, that they actually are true, that they're not legends, which brings me to the point of Amazon women, warrior women. You know, we've talked in earlier episodes about Spartan women and their contribution to the warrior archetype, which was mainly to support their men. But the Spartan women didn't actually fight. You know, they didn't actually have weapons. They weren't actually taking people on in battle. But according to the legend, there was this group of all female society, the Amazons, who really did that, who were the equal of men. And I know we've all seen Wonder Woman, and we've seen the whole thing of Diana and the magic lasso and all that, but that's really comic book stuff. But what I've always sort of wondered was, could it be true? Could there really have been a race of warrior women? And the reason we're here in this kind of setting is because supposedly from graves that have been found of warrior women buried with weapons and with horses, the Amazons, the ancient Amazons from say 1200 BC, were a horse culture. So they lived in, this was in the area of Ukraine, what is Ukraine now, around the Black Sea. So that would make a lot of sense to me. Now, just for fun, what do the legends tell us about the Amazons? One, they were an all-female society that would allow men in for maybe a month a year just for the purpose of procreation. And when they had babies, they would sell the boy babies and they would keep the female babies and raise them as warriors. So if we know one thing from present day, that young girls everywhere love horses, love to ride and just have a natural bond. So if we can imagine that they were horse culture living in a country like this, that's how they would grow up. Now here are some of the facts about, or the legendary facts about Amazons. The most famous one was that in infancy, they would take a hot iron plate and sear off the right breast so that that breast would not grow in the sense of being able to nurse. And the purpose of that was that that right arm could grow pure muscle to throw a spear, to draw the bow, or to throw the double-bladed axe, which were the weapons of the Amazons. That's one thing we know about them. We know, theoretically, this is the legend, that the Amazons were the first to fight with iron weapons and iron armor, way superior to bronze. They also were the first, supposedly, to fight as cavalry, not just as wild, crazy guys riding around on horseback, but in formations and doing that kind of organized fighting. So what's fascinating to me when I think about the Amazons is that they were, according to the ancient phrase, women unmastered by men. And it made me wonder, when I wrote my book, Last of the Amazons, what would a woman be like if women in general were not part of the patriarchy and didn't have men always holding them down? And also, what would they be like? Because in a patriarchy, when women are being held down by men, they have to express their power indirectly, you know, by sexualizing themselves or whatever. But if you had Amazon women that were the equal of men, that could shoot the bow, that could sling the double-bladed axe, that were on horseback, what would they be like? And, you know, would they be a whole other different race than we've ever thought of before? So, and again, speaking of the warrior archetype, which is why we're here, what would those women be like? How would they? We also know that women in all female groups have a whole kind of different dynamic. When you see You can see it today in athletic groups, in college, softball teams, women's hockey, women's volleyball, women's water polo. So it's a fascinating thing. We'll never know the answer to it, but I'm a believer that the Amazon race did exist. And we're going to talk about this in the next episode and talk about when the Amazon women supposedly attacked Athens and came this close to overcoming it.